Earlier this week, we discussed a disturbing report about the state agency charged with keeping our most vulnerable kids safe, the Department of Children and Families. The woman behind that report, State Auditor Suzanne Bump, joined us to go over some of the key findings, including in 2014 and 15, 260 cases of serious injuries they found documented by MassHealth, but not even known by DCF. Roughly a dozen and a half cases of serious abuse and or neglect documented by DCF, which were not reported to district attorneys, and more than 100 validated cases of sexual abuse, which were not reported to the Office of the Child Advocate, because sexual abuse does not rise to the level of a so-called critical incident, the auditor said, by DCF standards. It's a report that made the Republican governor, who usually goes out of his way to collaborate with Democrats, bristle.
We've put many new policies around investigative procedures. We never made any bones about the fact that when we took office, DCF had significant problems.
The governor also sent a letter to DCF employees saying, in part, I was dismayed to see the auditor put out an audit that relied on data that was 2 to 3 years old and talk about it like it happened yesterday, especially when everyone knows so much has changed at DCF since the fall of 2015. For this report to ignore nearly everything you've done for the past 2.5 years to improve the agency's ability to do its work strikes me as wrong. Joining me now is the Secretary of Health and Human Services, appointed by Charlie Baker, whose department oversees DCF, Marylou Sudders. Secretary, good to see you.
Good to see you.
Your boss also said, outdated and misleading at best, inaccurate at worst. I don't want to get lost in the weeds here, but what was most troubling to you and Governor Baker about this auditor's report?
Well, I think, in fact, that it was data from 2014 to the first part of 2015 and spoken about in present tense. I mean, the auditor actually said that the department continues to victimize children, and nothing could be further from the truth.
Well, but she said last night when Adam Riley was hosting the show, she said that there were 42% of serious medical incidents, serious bodily injury, that DCF was unaware of, and she contends the reason you were unaware of it is because you failed to cross-check with records from MassHealth, which is essentially Medicaid for Massachusetts, and if you did that, you would know about those things. And she says that practice continues. She's right about that, isn't she, or no?
That the department does not use...
That data.
Right, but that data is administrative medical claims data. It is not rich clinical information that would help a social worker understand what is happening with a child. As you know, we rely on mandated reporters, physicians who are in the emergency rooms, who are in physician offices. If a child came to them who had Medicaid, MassHealth, right, if they saw something, we require them to report to us.
But isn't more information always better? And if you ended up mining that data from MassHealth records and you found it not to be as relevant, as you say, as what you get from mandated reporters, then you don't use it. But there may be something in there, I assume you'd acknowledge, that is of value. Am I wrong about that?
So first of all, medical claims data is 3-6 months old. It's not immediate data available to you. And it's not data. It's really like procedure codes. Now, on an ongoing basis, would it be helpful to supervisors and for us to see as trends? Yes. But for a line social worker, it's not useful data at all.
You know, when you and the governor both talk, it's 2 years old. Do you know for a fact that in 2016 and as much of 2017 as has happened, that there's not a replication of some of these concerns that she voiced, she documented from 2014 and 2015, like this whole failure to report sexual abuse cases to the Office of Children's Advocate, the failure to report some of these serious incidents, including rape, to district attorneys? Do you know for a fact that they aren't continuing, even if not in the same numbers?
So what I can tell you today is the Department of Children and Families is completely different than what it was in 2014 and 2015. And let me speak to those two directly.
Sure.
So one, on referrals to the district attorney, the department had been using a policy that had been in place since 2008. And in 2017, the department, as part of the overhaul of the department, completely reformed its DA reporting policy. And if there is an allegation of sexual abuse or physical abuse, it is automatically referred to the district.
100% of the time.
Absolutely.
So that piece about non-referral of these cases, these serious incidents, to prosecutors from 2014 and 2015, she documented. Your contention is there is zero evidence of that continuing post-2015.
The policy is clear, and the department has put in an audit function to absolutely ensure, and that's actually even noted in the record.
You know, one of the things is most, I love a good political fight, I should say, and I miss the fact that there aren't as many good political fights. However, the one thing about which I can't stand political fights are kids. And the thing I don't understand here is the auditor told Adam last night, I believe, that he met with you, she met with you prior to this thing being released, and she included some of your responses, right?
She met with me the day the report was released.
Okay, the day was. And are you troubled by the fact that the governor's office and the auditor's office can't resolve these kind of differences so the people sitting at home who are totally lost in the weeds can be assured that you're and the administration are doing the job you are charged with, and I know you care deeply about protecting the most vulnerable kids? Is that not bother you?
The past 2 weeks have completely bothered me because the headlines are scathing and it's not reflective of the work of the department. Social workers do not come to work in the Department of Children and Families to do harm to kids. And as
well,
a social
she's not
worker,
claiming intent, by the way. I wasn't here last night. I assume Suzanne Bump is not saying it's the intention of social workers to not serve kids. You think there is that intent?
What I would say is that the headlines would suggest that the Department of Children and Families is not doing everything possible to keep kids safe. And one of the reasons Governor Baker wrote that letter to all 4,300 workers in the department, from line social workers to managers to supervisors, was to say that this administration is working with them to ensure that they have the tools and the resources to ensure that the kids of the Commonwealth are safe.
Do you think she's got an agenda? I know you're unlikely to answer that question honestly, but she's not a dope, and I assume you would agree. And so if she's as far off as you and the governor suggest she is, and is using his data that you contend is as outdated and irrelevant, what's the motivation? Is it incompetence on her part, or is it that she's got a political agenda?
No, I think the state auditor and the governor and I share the same goal of wanting to ensure that kids are safe in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. I think she sees this mass health data, these claims data, as a lens to child protection that we just don't see on the day-to-day basis of the department.
But if she's also citing things that you and the governor say from 2014 and 15 are completely outdated, that have, according to you two, have nothing to do with current events, does she not understand that, or she chooses not to understand that?
I think what she would say is that she did a report from 2014 to 2015 and has acknowledged that the department is engaged in reform efforts.
She called them heroic, your efforts, actually, with Adam Riley on Monday night. But, you know,
So I wish she had put that in the audit report.
Well, you know what she also didn't put in the press release, 2014 and 2015? Just says in 2 years. Does that lead you, I'm going to try one more time, to a conclusion, okay, that this is a politically driven report, or...
So I would like to believe that our elected officials, you know, do not use children for political gain, and only the auditor can answer that question. But what I would tell you, I'm an appointed official, and I do believe that all of us need to ensure that the Department of Children and Families ensures that the kids who are alleged to be abused and neglected get the services and supports they need.
And you're here tonight saying that the problems identified in that report, in your estimation, have all been addressed.
I believe that we have the policies and practices in place. We have the lowest caseloads ever in the Department of Children and Families history. Almost 100% of our social workers today are licensed. We have the first-time medical director in the Department of Children and Families.
So the answer is yes.
And we are making significant progress. But I would tell you, though, Jim, as you and I know, that the Department of Children and Families is always a work in progress, because we can't say our work will be done until no child is abused or neglected.
Marylou Sudders, nice to see you.
It's good to see you. Happy holidays.
Appreciate it. Same to you, of course.